Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to 12-17-12. We're in day five, man. And I'm just letting you know that the Seattle Seahawks are tearing it up. Okay, let's move on to other things. Well, today we're looking at Ecclesiastes chapter 12, which is just a pretty crazy book. And wow, I remember memorizing 12:1 when I was a teenager. And it simply says, "Remember now your Creator in the days of your youth, before the difficult days come and the years draw nigh, when you will say, 'I have no pleasure in them.'" In other words, pay me now or pay me later sort of thing. Let me tell you, if you're a young person listening to these or a leader of a young person, whatever the case may be, I want you to know there's nothing better than starting early remembering God. Because if you'll start early remembering God, God will give you equity in the account that you have with Him. There will be a personal history that you'll develop with Jesus. And it's your personal history that you use against the devil. It really is. So, right off the top, again, how do you beat it, man? Remember now your Creator in the days of your youth. And then I went on to read the rest of the chapter, and being a speaker or a minister, I just love verse 11. "The words of the wise are like goads, and the words of scholars are like well-driven nails given by one shepherd." And that shepherd would refer to God. So I have one word for this, or a two-word phrase: nail it. Every time you speak to somebody about the things of God, nail it. Use words that bring grace and life and make things really understandable to people. Jesus was really good at that. And I want to be good at nailing it every time I speak to somebody. And then, of course, this whole chapter just ends with, "Fear God, keep His commandments, for this is man's all." Then I went over to my journal, wrote down what I had here, and did a little study on, "This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it." And found out that the word "has made" refers more to "has brought about." And the context of this verse really is about the psalmist rejoicing that God brought a victory that day. And so, even though every day is a day to be given to God and it's a day He made, there are those days, those special days, when God just, well, shows Himself strong on our behalf. And we end up saying, "This is the day you made happen, Lord, and I will rejoice and be glad in it." So, again, am I give God 12? I'm just having a blast. And I want to be somebody who has words that are like well-driven nails so that I can nail it. Well, everybody, Christmas is coming. Jesus is Lord. And I thank God for what He's doing in our lives. Go Hawks.